Hi, I'm Shireesha Dhanireddy. I am professor of medicine in the University of Washington School of Medicine and also director of the Infectious Disease Clinic at Harborview Medical Center and chair of the UW Medicine Pharmacy and Therapeutics Committee. The initial rollout of vaccine nationally is in phase 1A, which will start next week or later this week, is to provide vaccine to all healthcare workers. In that first phase, specifically healthcare workers that are patient-facing. We have acquired or have those freezers in place at all of our hospitals so that we do have cold storage to be able to accept that mRNA vaccine, which is excellent. We are also working on our operations plan to make sure that everyone at each of the sites is able to get the vaccine. There is some reactogenicity with the vaccine, meaning that people can have a local site reaction, like pain or swelling, low-grade fever, body aches related to the vaccine within a day or two of vaccination. We're in a really good position to make sure that everyone who meets those criteria will be offered vaccine. Within a month of the vaccine rollout. And so the prioritization within that these groups is really to help stagger and to also maintain that surge capacity up front. The next phase is going to be phase 1B, which is going to be high-risk people in the community. And we're thinking people that are older, 65 and older, people with significant comorbidities. So that's a big chunk of people. And that is going to start hopefully end of January, early February. In terms of general population who don't have any risk, then we're thinking later on. And there also, as we get more data about other populations, we don't have a lot of pediatric data, obviously, yet, and in other special groups. So we may see those individuals vaccinated much later, towards the middle end of 2021. There are numerous benefits, not only for your own self-protection from COVID, but also to maintain our workforce capacity, to protect others in the community with whom we might have exposure, and to get towards the end of the pandemic. We are very hopeful with the arrival of these vaccines to be able to bring an end to this pandemic and to protect ourselves and our communities from COVID disease. It's really important during this time to continue our social distancing recommendations and masking to continue to prevent spread of infection while we work through our community to get people vaccinated.